The work that I had to do before starting the piece, going to visit the plantations in Louisiana and talking to some of the descendants and going to visit the archives. Those are the things that I want to try to do to make the piece authentic and to understand, you know, that all these things inform the piece. When I first came here to the archives, I felt, you know, blown away by just looking at how these documents have survived all these years, but also just the weight of the humanity and how, you know, these are people represented here and they all have different stories. I feel grateful to be able to tell the story, and music is a part of it. Well, music is such a powerful tool. It's amazing that it can reach emotions of people of varying backgrounds and cultures. Like playing piano in my dad's church and seeing how music could connect with people and then not really know. And so music is, in that way, it's important to me. You know, it's not just about the notes and the rhythms and the dynamics. It's about the story. It's about the emotion that it's telling. As a composer, I've always wanted to use music as a platform to talk about issues of our time, and it's personal for me in my artistic journey, in understanding how I fit, you know, as a black man, as a composer, how does this fit in the landscape, in the arc of our history? It's helpful for us to use music as a platform, as a means of discussion. I felt like the arts had to be a part of this in some way. And so the first step that I took when I decided to take this project on was to go to the archives on campus. I wanted to take the deep dive of really understanding the history and the stories, the individual, trying to find stories that may have been embedded and to the documents. And so went to the archives. I actually looked at the bill of sale and saw these names and the original handwriting, and I realized it's very small details, you know, but they told big stories. I came back from Maringouin, Louisiana, and after visiting the plantations there, I was sitting with these emotions, all of these feelings, and it was very heavy. And I actually didn't know where to begin. This is very special. It helped me kind of get through and just sort of help compose the piece. This is a jar of some of the soil from the Maringouin plantation. And it was given to me by one of the descendants. You know, it really helped me ground myself into the experience of writing the music. Like, you still feel the space of it. And I'm just wondering, like, how does that translate musically? It's just four chords for me. But it's the space itself is just like, and then the movement, that really helps. Music is, for me, is important, you know, as a personal outlet to deal with these feelings. Music of the Catholic Church is so rich, right? And so that was a way in. But also music of African Americans, equally rich. One of the elements of the piece is a hip hop spoken word. So I asked my friend Marco Pabe, who's also serving as the Georgetown artist in residence, to be a part of this project.
Waiting for each other,
I said to him, you know, I want to tell a story, and I want to use a medium that is sort of relevant to our time. And hip hop, the spoken word, is the pulse. You know, it's what's happening of our time. It's music. So I wanted him to do it. You know, he's a rapper, but he's also very poetic in his music.
At the bottom of patience, we all found heaven.
I wanted to use the different cultures and bring them together. And so that was the starting point for me. And I realized the Mass is a huge part of the music of the Catholic Church. And so I went to the Requiem Mass as a form. And the Requiem it's a very traditional art form. Mozart used it, Verdi used it, you know, Fauré used it. These traditional composers use this art form. But I wanted to use it to honor the enslaved. And so the piece takes the form of a traditional Requiem Mass, but also embed African-American spirituals into the art form. And I wanted to show that, you know, music has that power again of equalizing things, that we're all humans here. We're all universally made by God. And the music is saying that. Composing this Requiem really helped me understand my own cultural background. You know, my great-grandparents, their parents were slaves. And so that really helped me find a way in and to understand, you know, that link of being enslaved and to gain an appreciation. I wanted people to realize that this is, you know, is a sacred work. It takes the form of spiritual experience, if you will. And I wanted to make clear, you know, that we're honoring them, we're honoring the enslaved.